Steve Emerson knows the terrorist threat firsthand. His book and testimony before the Congress has made him a target. His life has been threatened ever since he came forward with his frightening discoveries about terrorist organizations right here in the United States.
Well, one of the problems is making people understand that there's a real threat. It's the deception of radical Islamic groups and the ability to perpetrate that deception among people wittingly and unwittingly accepting the fantasy that they are, quote, pluralists. They're not. They have one agenda. It's militant Islamic domination.
Jihad in America, a provocative new documentary that shows how terrorists have successfully infiltrated the United States. The film's producer and award-winning journalist Steve Emerson joins us here next. Our next guest says the Muslim Brotherhood and other radical Islamist offshoots are hiding in plain sight, right here in the United States. He's documented it all in a new documentary, Jihad in America, The Grand Deception.
The Muslim Brotherhood is an international movement, the goal of which is to create an Islamic state universally, all over the world.
Now is the documentary's producer, award-winning journalist Steve Emerson. Steve is also the director of the Investigative Project on Terrorism. Steve, it's good to have you with us. Thanks for being here. Let's start with the title of this documentary, The Grand Deception. Explain where that comes from, if you will.
Sure. Lou, the title Grand Deception actually came from a term that was invoked by a group of Muslim Brotherhood activists who secretly got together in Philadelphia in 1993 in a meeting that was actually wiretapped by the FBI. And in that meeting, and the wiretaps have been declassified, they openly talked about deception as the primary campaign tactic that they would use to change the image of Hamas and the Muslim Brotherhood in the United States by creating new front groups, by changing the terminology, by claiming they were against terrorism publicly, but in fact raising funds for Hamas.
Norwegian women in wheelchairs that are striking us in the heart of Manhattan. It's Islamic extremists, and it's their Islamic vision of hegemony. It doesn't mean all Muslims are part of a terrorist conspiracy. It doesn't mean that all Muslims are extremists. I honestly do not know how smart people in a society that prides itself on being so intelligent.
Not all of them are terrorists, Lou. I mean, they're radical in the same way that David Duke and the Ku Klux Klan are radical. Imagine if you had 150 KKK groups around the country being appointed to the State Department, being appointed to DHS, having their the indictments dropped. This is what's going on with the radical Islamic lobby under the tutelage of the Muslim Brotherhood, which created all these groups when it started coming here in 1963. It was a deliberate effort, Lou, to basically camouflage their true agenda, the agenda of creating an Islamic state. In the film, we used informants to secretly tape many of these Muslim Brotherhood groups behind closed doors, where they openly stated the U.S. will become a Muslim state.
But you also document a Brooklyn imam by the name of Siraj Wahaj, who, if we may, would like to share this clip of the documentary, because it's extraordinary. This man who in the early 90s gave the invocation before Congress. He is a powerful imam in Brooklyn right now, correct?
Correct. And as you'll see in the tape, he still, even though he was an unindicted co-conspirator in the 1993 World Trade Center bombing, and even though he made these radical comments, he gave the invocation to Congress, the first Muslim pastor to do so in 1991. And to this very day, he is still being invited and paid for by the U.S. government to appear at, quote, anti-terrorism conferences, like many others of his ilk.
Let's listen in to the Grand Deception.
In the name of God, most gracious, most merciful, guide the leaders of this nation who have been given a great responsibility in worldly affairs. Guide them and grant them righteousness and wisdom. I want to defend this country. You know what this country is? It's a garbage can. It's filthy. It's filthy and sick.
See, it's a powerful documentary. We're up against a hard out here. I want to just say to you, thank you for being here. We will keep this up on the site. Those who want to buy, go to Amazon.com to...